האנשים האלה, יש פה, יש סנטור, אישה לא יהודיה, שהיא באה לכאן לארץ ומביאה לפה קבוצות של אמריקאים לא יהודים, אוהבי ישראל, היא מראה להם את כל מה שקשור לנו, לבעיות שלנו מול השכנים שלנו, היא מראה להם לאנשים שלא היו פה אף פעם. היא רוצה להראות להם מה קורה כאן, איך אנחנו חיים זה לצד זה, על כל הבעיות המדיניות, הביטחוניות שלנו, והיא עושה את זה אך ורק מתוך אהבה לארץ. הייתה יוזמה שלי, שהיא תכיר, אבל היא כבר לפני שנה היא התארחה אצל משפחה דרוזית, היא ישנה אצלם בבית בחורפיש, והיום החלטנו להביא אותה לדלית אל כרמל לראות עוד איזה מקום, כי הוא קרוב גם, והיא לא הייתה פה אף פעם. היא לא הסתובבה בתוך היישוב הדרוזי.
אוקיי.
I want to ask you about the Israel people. What do you see in the United States? What do they think about our country, this small country, a lot of problems? What do you think of the United States about Israel, about the people that live in Israel?
Well, America is actually very confused about what Israel is really like. It's divided. Our public polls will say that 63% of all Americans support Israel. But the truth of the matter is, they may support Israel as a whole, as a nation, but they're very divided as to the inner workings of Israel. So giving up borders, giving up Gaza, pulling out of the north, things like giving up the Golan, different things like that. So I would say that for Americans, there's a great education that needs to happen. They need to learn about what the real heart of Israel is like. They need to understand, such as a Druzian community. They need to understand what it's like to live and to be a businessman here in Israel. America does not have that understanding yet, and it's why I'm here. It's why I'm trying to bring not only people over here, but also to write and to tell a story that first to Israel, there are a few of us Americans that are right here and we're going to stand with you. And we thank you for your strength because you are a tower to us, a real witness to us about standing strong. But it's also about educating the American people so that when they say, when 63% do say we stand with Israel, that they're truly standing with you and understand the security nature.
This is my first time in this country and so we've gotten to see the real people of this country, and they are the most warm, welcoming, wonderful people. They're so accepting of us. It's amazing to me how wonderful the people are. I just can't get over just the warmth. We're so enjoying this trip. We're so enjoying the people. We're enjoying seeing the sights and just seeing things that most Americans don't see. I'm amazed. I have more respect, better understanding of their way of life, and just more of a love for these people. They're just wonderful.
This is my third trip, and the first two times I was here, I was on tours. And this is a very intimate time to learn about the people and the cultures, and I'm having a wonderful time, and I'm willing to do whatever it is that I am supposed to do in the United States to help your people. I love this place, and I would like to live here. So here I am.
What we need here right now, it's a lot of love, a lot of care, and a lot of help from the United States people, because we are very, very love the United States, and I have here a lot of customers from the United States, from New Jersey, New York. Every 2 weeks I have 100 people here. So they share what was the problem, our problem with them, and they all the time say that they know and they need to help us.
That's right.
We need this.
Thank you. We're willing to do whatever it is that needs to be done, that we can do in our power.
They in the United States, they know about Gilad Shalit present in the Gaza. What do you think? What did they know about Gilad? What's happened here in Israel? So there is a solution to this problem?
Well, I don't think that most Americans even know about Gilad Shalit. I think that's something that is known amongst the American Jewish communities, but it's really not known by normal, everyday Americans. And you can ask some of these that are with me. knowing that Gilad Shalit is an army soldier that's been under Hamas control, what I believe that America can do most effectively is the Jewish community in Israel, all Israelis who care about Gilad, should be calling and lobbying the President of the United States, because he has relationship with Hamas leaders. He could pick up a phone and he could call Hamas leaders and he could say, you can release Gilad Shalit, bring him home to his family, let him go home, let the family see him, at the bare minimum, at least allow the family to see him, but bring him home. And he could recount to them that Israel has given up, their members, mm-hmm. and release them, so they have an honor, a responsibility to release. I believe that the President of the United States has a great influence into that, but it's going to take the people of Israel, who are very intimately knowledge of who Gilad is. Yeah. I apologize. Knowing who he is, to call him and to write those letters and send those emails and just lobby and lobby and lobby. I know on my website I put a whole story of who he is, so that the Americans could begin to understand what's going on. And I can tell you, just from a personal standpoint of having many family members in the military, if that was our soldier, we would be going in and we'd be bringing our soldier home, and he would not have been sitting there. So that's what I want to encourage Israel to do.
אני חושב שפשוט מאוד, ידוע לנו שבתפוסות בחו"ל, גם בחברה בארצות הברית לא יודעים שיש להם פרטנר, העם היהודי עם העם הדרוזי שנמצא כאן, זה השונה, אז הם צריכים לקבל גם את השונה. אני מנסה גם להעביר את המסר הזה שהעדה הדרוזית עד עכשיו לא קיבלה את הזכויות שלהם במלואם. אני חושב שדרכם אולי אפשר לשנות את התפיסה של העם היהודי שנמצא כאן, שגם אפשר לחיות עם העם הדרוזי בצורה יותר טובה, כי הדרוזים נתנו את הנשמה שלהם, ואני חושב שזה חשוב שהם באים לכאן לראות מה שקורה. עצם העובדה שהם באים לכאן, אז הם יודעים שיש איזו בעיה רצינית באוכלוסייה הלא יהודית במדינה, ובפרט אוכלוסיות קטנות כמו העדה הדרוזית והנוצרים שנמצאים כאן, שזה חשוב גם לנוצרים שנמצאים בחו"ל. אני חושב שהם, אכפת להם האוכלוסייה הנוצרית שנמצאת בארץ, רוצים לדעת מה המצב שלהם, איך חיים במדינה, איך מתקדמים, איך הם משתפים, איך הם מקדמים להם את האינטרסים של האוכלוסייה הנוצרית במדינה, ואיך הם חיים במצב טוב או לא. אנחנו צריכים ללמוד מהאוכלוסייה הזו גם לדאוג אחד לשני, כי פשוט מאוד חשוב לנו שיהיה לנו פרטנר כזה.